Hey there everybody, I'm Reload, and I wanted to talk to you about some cheap VR options out there. Say you already have your VR-ready computer, but you don't have VR headset yet, and you really want to try out some Oculus Rift or Steam VR games. As long as you have a VR-capable smartphone and some sort of a compatible headset, you can take advantage of a free app called VRidge by RiftCat. You will have to download a desktop program from RiftCat.com. And in combination with your Android smartphone app, you should be able to play most of the Oculus Rift and Steam VR games. Now I say most for a reason, but I'll get into that later on. The setup process itself is relatively easy. You just have to download the desktop program, register on the website and join the free beta. I'm already registered, so the website shows that I'm in beta. From here on in, it's time to launch your desktop program and pair it with your phone. You can search for the RiftCat or VRidge in your Google Play Store, and then launch the app once it's ready. You have a few options to connect your phone. You can do it through Wi-Fi or through USB tethering. If you do it through USB, make sure you turn off your cellular data just in case. The best way, of course, is to connect your phone through USB. That'll give you the fastest, most reliable connection. You just have to make sure that your USB cord is long enough to accommodate all the head movements. So now that your phone is connected, you can play a game through the RiftCat store, which actually has a lot of free Oculus games. Or you can play through VR games on your hard drive. Which you gotta say that I tried to play through the Euro Truck Simulator, but I just could not make it work. So I guess now is a good time to tell you that the system is very buggy. It really depends on your luck whether you're gonna get something to work or not. Because there's so many different phones out there, it's impossible to make each one work perfectly. But since the system is free, you really can't complain. Some games will work and others will not. But let me tell you what did work out for me. One of the Steam VR games worked perfectly. You can easily install Steam VR drivers to be compatible with the RiftCat. It's really just a matter of one click. The only thing you have to do afterwards is to configure your Steam VR. Before you get too excited, keep in mind that likely not all the games will work out for you. In fact, the developers tell you not to buy games just because you have RiftCat. But there's still some free VR games that you can try out. So let's set up Steam VR. Once you start it up, your RiftCat should launch automatically. And then you're gonna have to do the room setup. At this point, your phone is not really needed, but you can wait for it to sync up. Select the standing only option, because at this point you can't really track yourself in a room. Once the headset is ready, you can calibrate the center. Make sure you keep your phone steady in front of your eyes as if you're using it. And afterwards, you're gonna have to calibrate the floor. Personally, just leave it at zero. So far, it worked out well for me for the games that I've tried, but this is one of the things that you're gonna have to optimize for yourself. After this, the setup is pretty much complete. What you see in the bottom left corner of this video is the view from my phone. You can see that the quality is not that great, but that's partly due to the recording software taking up some of the CPU resources. I find that once I turn off the recording software, almost 90% of the artifacts are gone. You can try to adjust the number of artifacts by setting the streaming quality compatible with your phone. It's not a surefire way fix, but experimenting with the settings definitely helps. So the game that I tried with Steam VR is called InCell VR. It's a free game available for download from Steam, and it actually works surprisingly well with my current setup. On my computer screen, I can only see a lower resolution image of my in-game view, but within my phone, it's actually quite an immersive environment. The movements in-game are very responsive, and I can't spot any lag at this point. So next, I tried out one of the RiftCat store offerings, and I went for the Airborne VR 1944. It is freely available on the RiftCat store, and the simulation worked really well. Once again, my recording software on the phone took up way too much CPU, so the head tracking had a lot of lag, not to mention all the numerous visual artifacts that kept on popping up. But without the recording software running in the background of the smartphone, the quality actually was not that bad. It's not stellar, but for a free option, it's definitely more than enough. It really depends on the quality of your smartphone's display. Personally, I could still see each individual pixel, but from what I'm reading about dedicated headsets like the Oculus or the Vive, it's not really that uncommon to see pixels. It's also not a very easy plug-and-play solution. It will take you some time to really set it up for whatever game you'd like to play. For me, SteamVR setup was a breeze. It took no time to make it work. But for Euro Truck Simulator, it took me almost 6 hours to try to figure things out. And even then, it still didn't work, even though it's one of the games supported by VRidge. And please, do keep in mind that you still have to have a VR-ready computer to make this work. All of the Oculus and SteamVR games are still running off your system, and RiftCat simply uses your smartphone as the display. Also, be prepared for your smartphone to turn really hot trying to process all this information. But But regardless of all of these shortcomings, this is the best way I found to play VR games so far without a dedicated headset, and this is a relatively cheap system provided you have a VR-capable smartphone. Thanks so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments if you tried this and if it has worked out for you. The developers are very keen on making this app work, and I find that they respond very quickly on their forums. So if it's not working out for you, please do send them a message as well. Now that I have the system more or less set up, I'll be working on a few VR gameplay videos using my smartphone as the VR headset. Please hit thumbs up if you'd like to see more videos like this one, and subscribe to my channel for more gameplay videos. I'm Reload, and I'll see you in the next video.